Good morning. Today is Sunday, April the 11th, the second Sunday of Easter. On behalf of St. Juliana Falconieri Church here in Fullerton, California, welcome to those gathered here and those watching online. Today's Mass readings can be found on our parish website, stjulianachurch.org. Now, we invite you to visit the parish website frequently for updates and for faith information resources. Now, we invite you to prayerfully participate in the liturgy as we welcome our celebrants, Father Michael Pontarelli and Deacon Chuck Lauder.
Acknowledging the wideness of God's mercy, we pray in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God his Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
We've gathered together to celebrate the mystery of God's love this morning. Let us remember the way that we've grown in the love of God and the truth of the resurrection of Jesus Christ, and give thanks for the times we've turned away from our faith. We ask pardon and redirection to it.
You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
You came to call sinners. Christe eleison.
Christe.
Seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, and bring us to everlasting life.
King, O God Almighty Father.
us pray. God of everlasting mercy, who in the very recurrence of the Paschal feast kindle the faith of people you have made your own, increase, we pray, the grace you have bestowed, that all may grasp and rightly understand in what font they have been washed, by whose spirit they have been reborn, by whose blood they have been redeemed. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The community of believers was of one heart and mind, and no one claimed that any of his possessions was his own, but they had everything in common. With great power, the apostles bore witness to the resurrection of Lord Jesus, and great favor was accorded them all. There was no needy person among them, for those who owned property or houses would sell them, bring the proceeds of the sale, and put them at the feet of the apostles, and they were distributed in each according to their need. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting.
Let the house of Israel say, who fear the Lord say, his mercy endures forever.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting.
I was hard pressed and was falling, but the Lord helped me. Strength and my courage is the Lord, and he has been my Savior. The joyful shout of victory in the tents of the just.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting.
The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done. It is wonderful in our eyes. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us be glad and rejoice in it.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, everyone who believes that Jesus is the Christ is begotten by God, and everyone who loves the Father loves also the one begotten by him. In this way we know that we love the children of God when we love God and obey his commandments. for the love of God is this, that we keep his commandments. And his commandments are not burdensome, for whoever is begotten by God conquers the world. And the victory that conquers the world is our faith. Who indeed is the victor over the world but the one who believes that Jesus is the Son of God? This is the one who came through water and blood, Jesus Christ, not only by water alone, but by water and blood. The Spirit is the one that testifies, and the Spirit is truth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Seen me, says the Lord. Blessed are they who have not seen me, but still believe.
Alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On the evening of that first day of the week, when the doors were locked, where the disciples were, for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive are forgiven them, and those sins you retain are retained." Thomas, called Didymus, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples said to him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands and put my finger into the nail marks and put my hand into his side, I will not believe." Now a week later, his disciples were again inside and Thomas was with them. Jesus came, although the doors were locked, and stood in their midst and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands, and bring your hand and put it into my side. And do not be unbelieving, but believe." Thomas answered and said to him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you come to believe because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and have believed." Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples that are not written in this book. But these are written that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that through his disbelief, you may have life in his name. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Thomas the Apostle is one of my patron saints, literally. I chose Thomas the Apostle for my confirmation name. Remember, long ago, when I was confirmed, we were confirmed in grammar school. And you know that I'm veteran of St. Catherine's Military School and Anaheim's Little Army. And so when we got to choose our names, we had to tell Sister what name we chose. And I said, "Well, St. Thomas." "Oh, good, St. Thomas Aquinas, because they're Dominicans." "No, Sister. St. Thomas the Apostle, he's better than Thomas Aquinas, he's an apostle." Well, her face dropped and I probably got scolded. But that was a lot better than one of my best friends in the class. He chose William after William the Conqueror, and was told that that wasn't an appropriate name. I forgot what he chose after that or if he had to do anything. Anyway, Thomas the Doubter. Sometimes I hear, especially parents say, I'm all afraid that my child's becoming a doubter. Well, you know, doubt begins the inquiry. If you don't have doubt, if you're not curious, if you're not skeptical, you probably won't spend time to find out. And so Thomas, the doubter, the skeptic, he spent some time trying to find out exactly what it is that he didn't know and needed to know. Of course, he had the world's greatest ever teacher in front of him a week later. Let's sort of review the readings for today. They're a marvelous package. Begin with the first reading, that the community of disciples are one. They're one in keeping the commandment of Jesus to love one another as I've loved you. They don't give to the poor. They don't distribute everything among themselves and live in that kind of communal setting simply because they're good people. But rather, they're doing so for the love of Christ. The community is essential. Skip to the gospel. The first part of the gospel, the community is not together. Thomas is not with them. When Thomas is with them, the community is together, and they begin to understand the great truth of the faith, which brings in the second reading. Remember the faith that we have. The faith is not that we go out and be good citizens, caring for one another as people ought to care for one another. We care for them in Jesus' name, of course. But rather, that we remember the truth of the faith that we celebrated last Sunday and that we celebrate all the time. Jesus Christ, risen from the dead. What is it that Thomas could not understand? That the one who is dead has come back to life. What is it that he needs to do? Have some experience. Now, experience is a good teacher, and we're better learning from the experience of others often than we are from our own experience. Learn from your own experience and you'll get burned. Learn from someone else's experience and you'll have a good laugh. So remember, Thomas needed experience and he wanted to say exactly what all of us want to say. I'll believe it when I see it. But Jesus comes and he doesn't even get to experience it. Jesus comes and breathes life into him. Go back to the first reading. The idea that the community is going to be together, for what purpose? To become a new creation. The very first line of the gospel reading, the very first day of the week, we become a new creation. What happens at creation? Everything is made. What happens on the first day of the week? It's all remade so that we can live and live anew. So you see, these doubts become important because we grow through the doubt. These doubts become important because we can gather the data and find out that faith is not a blind leap in the dark. That's completely idiotic. Faith, like everything else, is a calculated risk. We want to gather the data and sift through the data, be sure that we have the right data and enough of it, to make a conclusion that's logical and put our conclusion out to be critiqued. Well, Thomas did that. He had enough data and he said, really? I'm not going to believe it until I see it. And then it's all made clear to him. You see, that doubt is overcome with the faith that we know. So genuine faith requires some of our own intellectual response. There are two great St. Thomases, of course. Thomas the Apostle and Thomas the Aquinas, the one who still had to go through an awful lot of sifting through truth. Those great tome of the Summa Theologica doesn't say that I simply came to believe this easily, but rather I did so because I needed to learn it. I needed to learn it for myself. Faith that's not interiorized is just off the shelf in someone else's. We can't get by any longer with saying, I believe it because sister said. There's no sisters to say it anymore. We can't get by anymore with, well, everyone knows it, because everyone doesn't know it. But what can we do? We can say it's the community that is together that is essential for the spreading of our faith. That is why the community divided really is harmful, isn't it? The community that is together and led, we will be led to the faith, certainly. But each one of us according to our own time. That's what we experience from Thomas, and that's what we experience from the Lord as well, saying, you'll understand it, I know you will, because I'm giving you the grace to open your mind. I'm giving you the grace to experience in your heart. I'm giving you the grace to go ahead and live it with your arms and your legs and every decision you're going to make. It's total conversion that we're interested in, the conversion of the mind, the conversion of the heart, the conversion of our behavior, which will shape the entire community. Let us be a community of one that professes first that Jesus is Lord, just as Thomas did. That's essential, that this Jesus who is Lord died and rose again so that we will rise to eternal life. This Jesus who is Lord, who died and rose, gave us a meal so that we'll have food for the journey, as St. Thomas Aquinas called it, so that we'll have strength to go out and experience the Lord anew every time, because in the Eucharist we experience the Lord himself as he really is, his real presence. So with that faith in Jesus who is divine, in the resurrection of this Jesus who is divine, in the food that he gave us for the journey, the community is gathered together to profess the faith. May we all profess strong faith in Jesus, especially as we celebrate it at Easter season. Not just one day, but a season of celebration, we go forth to live the faith, realizing that real learning begins with questions, doubt, and skepticism, or whatever you call curiosity. Aren't you curious to know more about our faith? Aren't you curious to do more about our faith? Aren't you curious to become a community of faith? Let us grow in the faith of Jesus today and always. God bless. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. The risen Lord appeared to his disciples with the gift of peace. Mercifully, he strengthened what was lacking in their faith. With peace, the Lord appears to us as we implore his aid for our doubting world.
That Christian assemblies were witness to the apostolic zeal of the early church, sharing their belief in Jesus risen from the dead and praising God night and day, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That political leaders will be formed in the Lord's mercy and justice as they seek to govern, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the gift of divine peace may dispel the doubt of all who reject the Lord, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the newly baptized may be fervent in their love of Christ and in their desire to reveal his love to others, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are sick among our family and friends may know the healing power of Christ, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the dead may be welcomed into paradise and share in God's everlasting love, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intention of the Mass this Sunday, for the parishioners of St. Juliana Parish and Catholic Grammar School, for Dr. Joseph Pierce Connedy, and for Wayne Webb, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Loving Father, your mercy extends to all the earth and summons us into one community of faith. May we learn to ceaselessly give thanks for the gift of your peace in our lives. Let no division separate us from one another or from you. Grant the prayers of your church through Christ our Lord, today and forever.
Amen.
Amen. Table is ready now. Pray that my sacrifice and yours may be found acceptable to God, the Almighty and loving Father.
May the Lord accept sacrifice to the praise and glory of his name for our good and good of all his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the oblations of all your people, that renewed by confession in your holy name and by baptism, they may attain unending happiness. Through Christ our risen Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him, the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising, the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all that you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your holy name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing. He broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer to you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saints Juliana and Peregrine and all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. But please to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis our Pope and Kevin our Bishop, his brother bishops, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you've gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you've summoned before you today. In your great compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There, we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
at the Savior's command and using the words that Jesus taught us, together we pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, O Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that, by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. O Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the table of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and that I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot be at this moment receiving you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Thank you.
Regina Celi,
Laetare, Alleluia, qui atque meruisti portare, Alleluia, resurrexit, sicut exit, Alleluia, ora pro nobis Deum.
Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that our reception of this Paschal Sacrament may have a continuing effect in our minds and hearts through our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. The Lord be with you. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you forever. Amen.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Alleluia.
God bless. Have a great day and a good week. God bless. Have a good day and a good week. God bless. Have a good day and a good week.